Welcome to an exciting escalation into the capabilities of ChatGPT. Join me as I push the boundaries of ChatGPT to generate Swift UI code snippets. Will ChatGPT rise to the occasion and seamlessly weave together the intricate syntax of Swift UI? Let's dive in and witness the fascinating interplay between human creativity and machine intelligence in the context of Swift UI development. And if you want to escape tutorial hell, go ahead and book a call with me at developer.com/mentoring. Now today we are going to ask ChatGPT to build us some sort of an application to help us with some code. And what I have done is just started a brand new Xcode project. Now we are going to give some prompts over here and let's see what ChatGPT 3.5 will give us. I'm going on the free version. Let's see how far we can go before we can break ChatGPT in this. And usually, as a word of advice, I heard that do not ask ChatGPT to just build a whole application. So we are going to test that. Let's see if we just ask some, okay, basic apps. Let's see if it can build it out. So first of all, let's just open up a new chat. And what I want to say to ChatGPT is that it is a Swift UI senior developer. So we want to say that, okay, this is you and this is your expertise. So it knows from where to get all of its information. And what it needs to do. So I will give him some prompts, some ideas, some questions, and it needs to spit out some Swift UI code. This is my end goal. So let's see. So I like to add, do you understand? So it actually knows that this is really, really important for me, for him, for it to know. Okay. So, let's start off with, let's say, a countdown timer application. Let's see, make sure that it knows that it is in Swift UI. So we'll use a date picker. Okay, let's see how this will look like. So this code defines simple Swift UI view with a date picker to set the target time and two text views to display the remaining time. The start countdown function uses a timer to update the remaining time every second, and the formatted time function formats the remaining time in hours, minutes, and seconds. Feel free to customize this code according to your requirements. Okay, let's see how if this code is actually valid. So let's jump into Xcode and let's just paste it in there. Well, I can just delete import Swift UI. We have the content view. And right over here, we already have closure captures timer before it is declared. So we have a timer. We want to set the timer actually outside. So we want to have a state private timer equals a timer. And then we can just say private var timer dot schedule timer. I believe that would work. No, let's see. Static member schedule timer cannot be used in instance of timer replaced with timer. Okay, that's really interesting. Okay, so we have a few bugs right off the bat. Let's see. Let's give it another go because I don't think that it can. So I will say that closure captures timer before it is declared. Let's see if it can fix it because I tried. This is also one of my, it's having an error on the, and let's see, start countdown function. Let's see. Okay, so we have a time interval. There is the timer. It's optional. Okay. Let's see if it got it right at this stage. So now the timer variable is declared as a state variable, making it accessible to the closure without any capture issues. This should resolve the error you encountered. Let's see if it fixed that problem. So let's have command A and command V to paste all of it. And it looks like it's okay. Let's just select one of our simulators right over here. Let's see if we actually get a timer. We have the date picker, select the target time, and it looks fine. Let's just see if it's going to work as expected. And if you have a few ticks, as you can see, it already fixed its previous bug. Let's just make sure. Embark on a personalized journey to elevate your iOS development skills with my exclusive mentoring sessions at developer.com/mentoring. As an experienced iOS developer, I offer one-on-one guidance to help you tackle your coding challenges and refine your app development expertise. Visit developer.com/mentoring to take the first step toward unlocking your full potential as an iOS developer. And here we go. We have a countdown timer. And then let's just select and now a countdown. And then, well, I don't see anything that's actually triggering the countdown timer. It says 1 second, thanks formatted time, remaining time. Formatted time for the remaining time. As you can see, you just have to. If it's less than zero, oh, maybe I just need to move this right over here. No? That's strange. It's not triggering the start count. Okay, so it looks like we already have some issues with the timer. So yeah, it's proven in my mind already that it's kind of hard to build up a whole application throughout only using just a prompt like, okay, write me a countdown timer app. As you already saw, we just had to tweak it a little bit. So what we are going to do is just take it one step at a time. So let's just see if we can create this countdown timer from small steps. And while we are doing that, we are going to tweak our code. So let me just go back over here and let's create a new chat. And again, okay. Okay, absolutely. Yeah, of course, he will just make sure that I know that he understood. Okay. So taking it one step at a time, let's see. Let's see what it's going to do. Maybe I understand. You'd like to create a countdown timer, okay. Could you provide more details on how you want the countdown timer to function? For example, what should the initial time be? Should it have the ability to set a custom time? And what kind of user interface elements are you envisioning? So I think we should just have a start value of 60 seconds. So you see now I'm just feeding some tips on how to build up this view. And let's see, what else should we do? Let's see if it can do that. Okay, so we have a countdown timer view. We have, I just moved really quickly over there. So we have, has a state property, seconds remaining to keep track of the countdown value. A timer is scheduled on the onAppear modifier and it updates the seconds remaining property every second until it reaches zero. The timer is stopped on the onDisappear modifier to prevent it from running in the background when the view is not visible. So yeah, that's a good extra thing that I did not ask ChatGPT, but it's a good thing to have. So let's see. I'm going to copy out the countdown timer view. There we go. Okay, let's copy that out. And let's move back to Xcode over here. And yeah, let's just replace everything over here. There we go. We have countdown timer view. And then let's see the content view. Okay, Just going to copy that out. And basically on the content view, we just set up a navigation view for that countdown timer view, which is fine. Okay, let's see if it's going to work now. As you can see, there's a lot less code over here, and it looks like it's much streamlined, and actually it is working. So as you can see, if you just feed it small chunks of code at a time, you can have much more results than just asking, okay, build me the Instagram map. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just have just a small tweak right over here. Let's see if it can add on the fly some view modifiers. So please set the timer to bold and red. Let's see. Just a quick note over here. Let's see, we have foreground color red and bold. Yeah, there it is. I don't even have to copy it out because I can see that it's right over here, and I'm just going to copy that out, go back to Xcode and paste it right over here before the on appear. That's where it is. Let's indent this line. There we go. Let's build and run and see how it looks like. And yeah, this is how you would just build out your code. And as you can see, it's phenomenal. Now, let's just see if it's actually going to stop. Well, it is going to stop once it's not going, you know, once it's less than zero, it's not going to extract 1 second from the seconds remaining. Still, the timer will be scheduled and it's going to invalidate when this view disappears, which is really nice. So coming back to my thought over here, you can also use ChatGPT to actually tell you what a code does. So let's just grab all of this code. Of course, it just written this, but let's just test it out. Let's create a new chat and then again. So many times, you know, you get into a code and you don't really know what it means. So let's paste that in. Let's see if it can just make sense of the code that I have given it to it. So certainly this Swift UI view defines two views. Let's just see. A countdown timer view and content view. Let's break down the code step by step. Countdown timer view. We have a state private var. Seconds remaining 60. This declares a state variable named with an initial value of 60. Yes. The state property wrapper is used to create a mutable state variable that SwiftUI can monitor for changes. That's a good extra information right over here. Then we have the timer. This declares the computer property named timer of type timer. It uses the schedule timer method to create a repeating timer with a time interval of 1 second. The timer is configured to execute the closure provided as an argument every second, decreasing seconds remaining if it's greater than zero. Now, this is amazing because yes, it's exactly what it does. We have the body. This is the main body of the countdown timer view. It consists of a text view displaying the current value of the seconds remaining. The text has additional modifiers to set the font's title size, make it bold, and set the text color to red. Two on appear and on disappear modifiers are used to start and stop the timer when the view appears and disappears respectively. Really great. Now the content view, the body, this is the main body of the content view. It embeds a countdown timer inside the navigation view and sets the navigation title to countdown. It's exactly what it is. So in summary, the code creates a simple countdown timer using SwiftUI. The timer starts at 60 seconds and decrements every second until it reaches zero. The countdown is displayed in a view with a navigation bar title, countdown timer in the content view. The timer is started when the countdown timer view appears and stopped when it disappears to avoid unnecessary resource consumption. It's exactly what this code does. Now, of course, we just written this relatively simple code, and I'm really, really pleased that it could just explain it to me really, really well. Now, what if I just give it some really complicated code? This is an observable object, and it's a dynamic property that it's using this observable project. Also, some the requester are missing from the context from ChatGPT. Let's see if it's going to know what This does. Explain me now this code. Okay, let's paste it in there and let's hit it away. So basically what this does is just creates a property wrapper around URL session. Let's see if it's going to actually guess this. Let's see, this code defines a Swift package that provides a mechanism for making network requests and handling the result in a Swift UI app. Let's break down the code. So it's actually not a package. It's just a view modifier, well, a property wrapper. Sorry, not view modifier. Okay, so main actor, yes. Private request. We have a property wrapper. Okay, in summary, this code provides a structured way to handle network requests in Swift UI by encapsulating the request logic and result handling in the request result manager class. The request result property wrapper is then used to integrate this functionality into Swift UI views. Like it's really amazing. It's really, really great. Now, finally, what I would like to see is that it could just handle some sort of an error. Something went wrong. I know we just tried to do this in the beginning of our tutorial. So let's make some big mistakes over here. So let's see. Well, big mistakes. Let's see if we can just. Well, small mistake. Let's remove the dot from the board. So let me just copy out this code and paste it in a new chat. Let's create that right over here. Again, this should be a relatively simple to fix. Let's see. It looks like there are a couple of issues in your code. Here's an updated version of it. Okay. So move the dot bold modifier to the correct place. Let's see. Yeah, the correct place, meaning, just added a dot and just moved it one character behind. Enclose the text view within a VStack to avoid any layout issues. Let's see, what's that VStack? Yeah, that's fine because, yeah, maybe you're just going to put this into a horizontal stack. Add a countdown time preview struct to conform the preview provider protocol to previewing in the view in Xcode. So overall, I'm really, really satisfied with the fix. And yeah, basically it did what I asked it to do. So overall, what you should do when you are coding with ChatGPT is think of it like an assistant. You don't want the assistant to be overwhelmed, like build me this app and it should look like this and that and it should have these functionalities. No, you should take it one step at a time and then improve, maybe have some bug fixes, and it can handle it really, really nicely. Also, if you don't understand some code, just give it and make sure that you always specify that it is an expert in that field. In our case, it was a Swift UI senior developer. Now, if you did like this video, make sure to check out how ChatGPT built this app UI for other mail app. Go ahead and check it out. It's right over here.